he will strive to hinder you in service for the Lord. He will insinuate that you are doing no good. He'll have people who benefit from your ministry who will never say a word of encouragement on purpose, because the devil and they don't want you to know you're doing good. And that you want rest, he will endeavor to make you weary of suffering. He will whisper, curse God and die. And like Job's wife, the devil through her will say, why don't you just curse God and die, husband? But make sure the insurance payments are paid up. Or he will attack your steadfastness. May I add, your unmovableness. You're always abounding in the work of the Lord. For those of you who serve the Lord, you know that once God, if you're faithful to God, once God lets you finish one assignment, you think you're going to go on a vacation, God has two or three more assignments for you. I believe he believes in the principle, the person who you get the most out of is the person who's already doing something. I don't know. What is the good of being so zealous? Be quiet like the rest. Sleep as do others. And let your lamp go out as the other virgins do. Oh, my soul. Oh, this is so real. This is so real. I tell you, this brother had the mother load, man. And see, you can't talk like this unless you experienced it. And you can't laugh like I'm laughing unless you have experienced it. Whoa, isn't it amazing how a man being dead yet speak of many, many years can make me laugh along with him and agreeing with him, having a kindred spirit. It's just amazing. Or he will assail your doctrinal sentiments. Why do you hold to these denominational creeds? Why do you hold to these biblical creeds? Why is it like Billy Sunday said, you always got to rub the cat the wrong way? Billy Sunday said, in response to that question, tell the cat to turn around. The other day when the people were dancing in the street, partying in the street, every channel you looked at, the flag you saw, you thought it would be the Black Power flag or something. But no, you saw the homosexual, sodomite, gay flag everywhere. And I said, okay. And there's going to be crying and boo-hooing in the streets if the church and the government does not repent of sanctioning homosexuality, sodomy, homosexual marriage, and homosexual adoption. See, some of you right now, you're mad because I would interject that. I'm just telling you the truth. You may think you're going to get rid of this plague. That's fine. But a worse plague is coming. Anyway, sensible men are getting more liberal. They are removing the old landmarks. Fall in with the times, prophet, preacher. don't say anything about the sodomites. Why are you always rubbing the cat the wrong way? Go along to get along. Get along to go along. Wear your shield, Christian. Therefore, close upon your armor and cry mightily unto God that by his Spirit you may endure to the end. Persevere.